So you probably know there are multiple investigations of Donald Trump active right now, let alone all of the investigations that have come before. And there's been a number of interesting developments as well as seeming setbacks, and it can get quite frustrating. I know a lot of people are frustrated about the state of these investigations. They are desperate for some sort of consequences to come forward. Well, we're very lucky that we're gonna engage in a debate about some potentially fruitful paths going forward for these investigations. And we're gonna be doing that with one of my favorite people to break down these sorts of topics with, Pulitzer Prize winning investigative reporter and the co-founder of DCReport.org, David K. Johnston. Welcome back to the Damage Report.
Glad to be here.
Always glad to have you here. So there's been some setbacks, but as we were talking about before we went live, you believe that there is a path forward for some of these investigations, particularly the New York one.
Well, this is a foolproof way. New York state law provides that the governor has unfettered power to replace any district attorney in any criminal case by appointing the state attorney general to take over the case. I wrote a piece about this last week for the New York Daily News opinion pages, and both an eminent constitutional scholar at Columbia Law and the legendary white collar crime prosecutor John Moscow said, I've got it exactly right. By the way, I'm not a lawyer, but I do have for many years taught law at Syracuse University's College of Law. And at DC Report, we run something we call action boxes. So when there's a federal regulation proposed that you might not like, we tell you, here's how you can put comments in. Well, in this case, we published Governor Kathy Hochul's office telephone number. Mm-hmm. And if people call, enough of them call that it ties up her phone for days, I suspect she will stop dodging this issue. She should be held to account about this. Either she's going to let it die, she's a Democrat, why would she let this die? Or she's going to act. And so DCReport.org, on our homepage, there's a photo montage of Donald behind bars, and just read down to our action box. And we've done this, we've actually had success with this in the past. Governor Cuomo, her predecessor, changed one of his policies after his phone lines were tied up for days. Because we believe in empowering readers, not just saying, well, there's this and there's that, it doesn't mean anything.
So I wanna ask you a question that you just asked. So why would she let it die? Like you've laid out the path, it's apparently she can do this. Why, first of all, why do we even get to this point? Why has this seemingly been set to the side? And why would she, as a Democrat, knowing all that we know about what Trump has done, not want to vigorously pursue this?
Well, the reason this case is dying, if not dead already, but it could be revived, is that the newly elected district attorney for Manhattan, Alvin Bragg, is afraid that Trump would get a hung jury. And according to the chief prosecutor, Mark Pomerantz, who is the expert in the country on how to prosecute this kind of a case, I mean, he literally wrote the book on it. Bragg is fearful that they can't show criminal intent by Trump. Showing criminal intent by Donald Trump is real easy. Witnesses will testify, he was given this legal or accounting advice, and he said, to hell with that, do the following. Mm-hmm. That's criminal intent, and it wouldn't be hard to prove. So his real fear has to be a hung jury. Well, okay, you get a hung jury, you get a hung jury. You usually get a second bite at the apple if that happens. One case that I wrote about years ago in LA, it was a kid falsely accused of a murder who was tried five times before he finally got acquitted because of the evidence. Now, why is Hochul dodging this? Well, Hochul is facing a very well-funded campaign against her by a Trump Republican. Trump Republicans aren't gonna vote for Hochul under any circumstances, so I don't see any loss to her. However, with people who are in between, who aren't necessarily pro or anti-Trump, she may feel there's some risk. After all, if she does nothing and no one knows about it, mm-hmm. It didn't appear in the New York Times, after all, my former newspaper. I offered them the story and notified them when the New York Daily News and DC Report pieces ran, and they've still not said a word. And if something doesn't appear in the New York Times, it doesn't get known, because every significant news executive in America and much of the world, first thing they do when they get out of bed in the morning is read the New York Times. Mm-hmm. So if the Times doesn't report it, nothing's going to happen. Therefore, there's no risk to her. There's no political cost for letting Donald Trump off the hook. But this is a perfect example of where citizens can have an impact. You know, they can show up at her office in a group in Albany if you live nearby and protest. But you can easily just call her phone. If you don't live in New York State, by the way, come up with a town and a zip code, because the first thing they'll ask you is what zip code do you live in? And if you don't have it, they'll hang up on you.
Yeah. Yeah. And by the way, it's not like you're asking people to pressure her to unilaterally throw him in prison or something like that. It is simply to allow the legal process to continue. He would still have every opportunity to defend himself, and I'm sure he would, with a number of incredibly high priced attorneys, but at least we would have the chance. Well, so that hardly seems radical.
I'm certain that some people who call will say, please let the case go and leave Donald Trump alone. Okay, but our underlying point at DC Report, our philosophy is we cover what politicians do, not what they say. And you should own our government. We own our government. We should act like owners. Too many of us act like squatters or renters. Be an owner. Take charge. Tell the people who work for you. Joe Biden works for you. He is your subordinate. You're the boss. Tell Kathy Hochul, the governor, this is what we think you should do since you've been given this power.
Based on what you've seen of Hochul so far, how do you see this playing out? I mean, obviously people can get involved, they should. Do you think that there's a good chance?
Well, I think she's proven to be a very solid administrator. I live in Western New York. I think she's proven to be, surprisingly, a very solid administrator. What we don't know, very frankly, is does she have a spine of steel or jello? We just don't know. And I think this is a perfect testing ground. Are you gonna stand up for truth, justice, and doing the right thing, or are you going to let Donald Trump slink away from his many crimes?
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.